Hey guys, hello everyone and welcome to the channel. So in this video we'll talk about carbon 13 NMR depth spectroscopy. Depth means distortionless enhancement by polarization transfer. Okay, so we'll try to understand this. So this technique is basically used to differentiate between like different kind of carbon, different kind of hydrogen containing carbons, like your CH unit, CH2 unit and CH3 units. So there are basically three kind of depth spectroscopy. One is your depth 45, one is your depth 90, and the third one is your depth 135. Where 45, 90 and 135, basically they are flip angles at which two different radio frequencies flip, like at which angle the radio frequency flips. So I'm not going to tell you these things in that context. Like I'm not going to be in the literal context of the carbon 13 NMR depth. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to talk about this topic from the problem solving point of view, okay, from the application point of view, that what are the information that carbon 13 NMR depth gives you and how you can use that particular information to solve question to identify a particular organic compound. Okay, so in the following clips you will get to know that what this carbon 13 NMR depth is and how you can assign or how you can determine the particular correct structure of an organic compound based upon the different depth data. Okay, now before starting that, if you are new to this channel, please subscribe to this channel, and after watching this video, if you like this video, give it a like. And so in the following videos and at the end of the video, I have given some questions for you to solve. So I hope you guys will watch this video till end and you will give the solution of those questions in the comment section below. So that's all. So this table over here, it tells you that all the information is in a summarized way. It tells you that what kind of signals you will get in depth NMR spectra, depth carbon 13 NMR spectra of a given compound. So these are different depth, like depth 135, depth 90, depth 45, and normal, that is normal carbon 13 NMR spectra, okay, proton decoupled carbon 13 NMR spectra. Now as you can see that there are different kind of carbon. This is a quaternary carbon. This is a tertiary carbon like CH, then this is a secondary carbon, and this is the primary carbon, okay, like CH3, like methyl radical, or you can say methyl group, and CH2 group, and CH group, and C. So what you are expecting in a 13 carbon decoupled NMR spectra, over there you will get peaks for all these kind of carbon, right? So positive means you will be getting all peaks in the positive direction. Okay, I'll show you the spectra, don't worry about it, but just from the table you can get that, okay, for carbon 13 NMR you will get all the peaks as positive. For depth 45, okay, it is your depth 45. For depth 45, this quaternary carbon, it will not show any peak, okay, so it will be suppressed and you won't get any peak for that. So that's why this zero is written over here. Now you will get a positive peak for CH group, you will get a positive peak for CH2, as well as you will get a positive peak for CH3. So all these hydrogen containing carbons, they will give you positive peaks. Now what about your depth 90? So in depth 90 you won't get any peak for C, that is the carbon which does not have hydrogen, that will not give you any peak in that, and you get a positive peak for CH group. Okay, so if you have a CH group in your compound, it will give you a positive peaks. Rest of the others like CH2 and CH3, they won't give you any peak. Okay, now talking about your depth 135, so your depth 135 is of the most important one, and it will give you a lot of information. You can distinguish among the like hydrogen containing carbons. So this will also not give you any peak for just a carbon, okay, that is quaternary carbon. It will give you a positive peak for CH unit, carbon containing hydrogen. It will give you a negative peak for CH2 unit, okay. So remember, it gives a negative peak for CH2 unit, and it gives a positive peak for CH3 unit. So these are the, like, this table summarizes everything in it. So remember, your depth 135, it gives negative peak for CH2 unit, positive peak for CH and CH3 unit. Okay, let's see that how the spectra will look like. So over here, it's a distortionless enhancement by polarization transfer, that is depth spectra. Okay, depth spectra of a given compound. This is the compound over here. Now you can see that how many carbons this compound has. So it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 carbons, right? So there are total 6 kind of carbons, and they have been labeled as A, B, C, D, E and F for the sake of understanding that where the peaks will be, okay? So over here you can see this is your proton decoupled carbon 13 NMR. And over here, all the peaks, you are getting peaks for all of them. Like you are getting peak for A, you are getting peak for B, for C, for D, for E, for F. Okay. So for all six carbon atoms, you are getting a peak. Now, the thing you have to see over here is that this one, that is your this carbon number C. Okay. Just focus over here. So carbon number C is the carbon which does not have any hydrogen attached to it. So there is no hydrogen attached to it. So it's just a carbon, okay? And remember, I just told you that in the depth spectra, you don't get any peak for a carbon that does not have hydrogen, okay? So that's why the peak, because of this, that is peak number C, that is not in any of the depth. Like here are the depths, right? So it is depth 45, depth 90, and depth 135. So you don't get any peak corresponding to this carbon, like corresponding to carbon number C. Whereas you are getting the peak for corresponding to carbon number A, carbon number F, B, D, and E in different depth. Okay. Now let's start from depth 45. So I told you that depth 45 gives positive peak for CH3 as well as CH2 as well as CH. So your A is your CH3, right? A is CH3, B is CH2, D is CH, E is also CH, and F is your CH3. So you get positive peaks for all of them. Okay. So that's why you are getting positive peak for A. This peak, this particular peak correspond to A, this particular peak correspond to F, this is for B, this is for D, and this is for E. So you are getting peak for all of them except C, because carbon number C was actually a carbon that does not have hydrogen. Okay, so that's why it is not giving you peak over it. So depth 45 is not of that use. It will just tell you that how many hydrogen containing carbons are there. That's all. Now depth 90 will give you information that how many CH units are there. Now if you see your compound, your D and E, these two carbons are CH, right? If you fulfill the valency of the carbon, you will see that this is CH and this is also CH, D and E. Both of these positions are having CH. So that's why the peaks at D and peak at E. So you are getting peak at D and E position due to both of these CH units. Okay, so that's why you are getting peak over here. So depth 90 will just give you information about the CH. The others will be suppressed over here, like CH3, CH2, and C. They all will be suppressed over here. Now talking about depth 135, this will distinguish and this will give you more detailed spectra. Over here you will get positive peak for CH3 and CH unit. So CH3 is your A. Then you have F. F is also CH3, right? So A and F both are CH3, and D and E were CH3, right? So for A and for F and for D and for E, you are getting positive peaks, whereas it gives a negative peak for your CH2 unit. So B, carbon number B is your CH2 unit, because it will be OCH2 CH3, right? So this is the CH2 unit. So that's why you're getting a negative peak, the peak in the downside of it. So that's how your depth 135 will give you, like it will differentiate between CH2 and the other type of carbon containing hydrogen. Okay, so that's how the peaks, and that's how the spectra will look like. Fine. Now let's take the question and let's see that how we will solve that. First, in your in CSIR June 2016 exam. Okay, so the question says that the correct structure of the compound which shows following carbon 13 NMR depth 135 data. Okay, so the question was on your depth 135. Now it gives you data, the data is given to you, so it gives you negative peak. Negative peaks you are getting at 30.2, then you are getting at 31.9, then 61.8, and 114.7. So this is the negative peaks which you are getting at these ppm. And you are getting positive peaks at 130.4 ppm. Okay, so these are the negative and positive peaks which are given to you. Now, to solve questions from depth, the position of these peaks are not that important, or I would say that is important, but this question can be easily done with the help of just the number of peaks. Okay, so the first approach, the first thing which you should do is to find out the number of peaks which you are getting, number of positive and negative peaks. So the negative peaks are, how many negative peaks you have? So 1, 2, 3 and 4. So you have 4 negative peaks and 1 positive peak. Now remember the property or the what your depth 135 gives. So basically that gives you positive peak. It gives you positive peaks for what? It gives you positive peak for CH3 unit and CH unit. So for CH3 and CH unit, it gives you a positive peak, whereas it gives a negative peak for your CH2 unit, right? So for CH2 unit, it gives you a negative peak. So that means the given compound, like in the options, the compound should have 4 CH2 unit, right? Because you have 4 negative peaks. So it should have 4 CH2 unit, and it can have one either CH3 or CH unit. So let's try to find out that which of these have 4 CH2 unit. Now in the option 1, if you see, so over here you have CH2, here you have CH2, here you have CH2, and over here you have CH, right? And over here also you have CH2. So how many CH2 units you have in option number 1? So in option number 1, you have 4 CH2 units and 1 CH unit. So that means 4 negative peak and 1 positive peak can be given in the option number 1. So yes, option 1 can be our answer. But let's try to see that whether any other option gives you this kind of data or not. Okay, so this is our probable answer, but let's see the other options as well. So option number 2, it gives you CH3 over here, you have CH2 over here, you have CH here, you have CH here, and you have CH2. So for option number 2, how many negative peaks will be there? So there will be two negative peaks, okay, two negative peaks, and it will have three positive peaks, okay, so three positive and two negative peaks. Now talking about option number 3, so option number 3 over here, it will have CH2, it will have CH, it will have CH2, it will have CH2, and it will have CH3. So CH and CH3 both gives you both of them gives you positive peaks. So two positive, okay, two positive and three negative peaks in option number 3. Let's take option number 4 then. So here you have CH3, here you just have carbon, so it won't give you any peak in your in the depth, right? And over here you will be having CH2 unit, here you have CH2 unit, here you have CH2. So you get 3 negative because of 3 CH2 unit and 1 positive unit, like 1 positive because of CH3. So the only option, so first one gives you, it gives you 4 negative and 1 positive. So the only option which gives you 4 negative and 1 positive peak is your option number 1. So our correct option becomes option number 1. So like that you can easily answer, you can easily do. So this was in the last few years, the only question asked from depth NMR spectroscopy was this one only. I found this in June 2016. If you have any other question, you can send me out. I will try to solve it and I will try to help you in that. Okay. Now I will give you two questions for your practice so that you can also practice it up and you can answer me, you can tell the answer in the given comment section. Okay. Screen. And these are for your practice purpose. So you have to find out, so the question is that find the number of positive and negative peaks in 13 carbon NMR depth 135 spectra of the following compound. So here is the compound number A. So the compound is over here given as A, labeled as A, and this is compound number B. Okay, so what you have to do, you just have to analyze the compound and you have to tell that how many positive and how many negative peaks you will get. That's all. Okay. And post your answers in the comment section, and if you got it, so please share with your share your answer in the comment section. So that will be just like a self-assessment. You will get to know that how much you have understood, right? So that's all for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, give this a big thumbs up, and if you are new to this channel, please subscribe to this channel for more updated videos. So thank you so much. Have a great day.